MISP really is an amazing tool. It can tie together all of your threat feeds, your security analysis tools, your public databases, and your other data into a single meaningful view whenever you're gathering information for analysis on an event or something dodgy in your logs. In this video, I'm going to show you how to tie together all this information using the MISP virtual machine that's completely free. And whether or not you're in a big organization with a lot of tools, a lot of vendor resources, a lot of paid feeds or other resources, or whether or not you're a small team or a small department or even just alone and having to do all this analysis work, MISP can provide you the information you need to do your job better and in a more streamlined fashion. It's really quite amazing, and I keep getting shocked by its capabilities every time I use it. Hi, my name is Jordan Schroeder, and it is my passion to help business and security leaders take their security program to the next level. Because if we can all do this right, we all win. And like all of my videos, down in the description field, there is a CPE tag text that I've created that you can import into your CPE tracker, so you can get credit for watching this video for your certifications at the end of the year. But remember, you can't use this video for credit unless you watch it all the way to the end. If you like this video and you want to get alerted to when my next video comes out, click the subscribe button and click the bell, and you will get that alert so you know when the next one comes out. So let's get right into the demo and I'll show you what I mean. Here I have my demo MISP version, and it's fairly bog standard. I haven't done anything to it. I haven't changed it. All I've done is enabled many feeds in order to populate the threat intel. And how to do that and how I set that up is in the other video that I have, in the other demo, and I've got the link to that up above on this video. So here we have the list of all of the different feeds that we've got and all the list of different events that we have in our MISP instance. Now let's go through a scenario where we imagine that we have a new incident or a new event. And this is fairly easy. So we'll add a new event and we'll give it a quick description. And this creates the basic template and the basic format for the event, but it doesn't have any data in it. Then let's take a look at adding some data. So let's add the IP, let's do an IP source. Let's submit that, and now let's add a domain. And in my investigation, I saw a really sketchy domain called google.com. Let's add that. And then let's take a look at a MAC address. And add this MAC. All right, so we have our incident and we have the three pieces of data that we've collected from our incident and we've added it to the event. That's great. Now, right away, because we have all these feeds, MISP has cross-correlated this information that we've added to the rest of the data that's in MISP. This alone is very, very powerful. So let's take a look here at our super sketchy google.com domain, and we see that it's got related events. We have some information in a blog, and we also have other generic information. We also see here in red that there is an event, and this event is the one that I've created, the one event, the only one event I've created for this demo, and it's also shown up in another incident, another event within the organization. So not only does this cross-correlate with external information, it can cross-correlate with the internal information that you start gathering as you gain experience and as you start analyzing the events in your organization. All right, so it's got all this here and we see this IP. Wow, that's in a lot of different places. We've got a mail spam, SQL injection vulnerability sites, and there's a lot of others. Apparently this IP is really super sketchy. Now that we have this information, we want to be able to take the next step, right? We want to be able to learn more about this. We want to enhance or enrich this information to get a better idea of what's going on. Now we've got lots of different information we could pull from, But wouldn't it be nice if we could do this within MISP? And we can. You have to go and enable a lot of these different enrichment options. If you look up here on the side, you will see the Enrich Event button. And if you click it, there's really nothing there except for something default. If we want to be able to enable those enrichments, we go here to Server Settings and Maintenance, Plugin Settings, Enrichment, and you can see all of the different options, and there are quite a number, as you can see. All right, now I'm interested in a few of them, and I'll show you just the selection I've chosen for this demo. You've got options for free and paid connections. So if you look here, you've got passive total, virus total. These things tend to be paid in order to get access to them and get the API keys. Some of the stuff requires an external Whois server or a DNS server, but there's a lot of other information that you can get just for free. I just want to show you a quick summary to get you an idea as to how MISP uses it. So I'm going to look here for DNS. So we're going to enable this, and bear with me, and I'll speed this up as I run through. Okay, so we have enabled a bunch of these different options. As you can see, there are quite a number. And now let's go back to that event. If we come back to this event and we open this up, we can see that MISP has put in the related events and the information that's been correlated up at the top for ease of use and ease of finding. And just underneath that, we can see the related feeds that have fed those things as well, which is a convenience. Now we can see here for each of these attributes that there is a magnifying glass. Those weren't there before. And each one that has been enhanced has this magnifying glass. If you click it on the Mac, we can see it's pulled from the Mac database. If we go down to the Google, to the domain name, we click on that, we get a DNS result. That was one of the enhancements that we enabled. And for the IP, we can see the ASN data that's been pulled from the database from that enhancement. Like it's one of the ones that I enhanced as well, that I enabled as well. Now, if we just hover over them, they will pop up as well. And these are known as hover enrichments. So this is the stuff that typically comes from a database or a lookup database that's simply been added to MISP. If we come up here to the enrich event, we can see the more involved ones. We've got DNS, the ASN information, and the URL scan. If we do the DNS, they start as background information, and they run across everything that applies, every attribute that applies within the event. We hit a refresh to get this information to show, and we can see that for the DNS, which is what we clicked, the domain name for Google has been enriched and has been added as an attribute to the event. This can be helpful if you want to include this and have it as something to play with within the event as well. You can see here it's the Google IP address. What we're going to do now is going to add another domain, and I'm going to show you the URL scan and the more involved types of enrichments. So we're going to add the domain, and it's the Hephaestus domain, which is my company domain. We're going to add this as an attribute, and now instead of going to the enrich event option and running URL scan, that'll run across all the other domains. And that's not necessarily what we want to do when we're talking about stuff like Google. And you see here, it's tried to pull in all this other information. What we're going to do instead is we're going to get really targeted. So here we have this one domain, really only want to know what this one domain is doing. So we are going to come over here and we can see that there is an add enrichment option. So we're going to click this and we're going to click the URL scan. And here we go. It's finished its work. And this is the results from the URL scan enrichment. And it's got all of these options and we have the ability to include them all or pick and choose which ones we want. And we can then add this to our enrichment. And I took a refresh of the page to have that information show up, but here's all the information, including screenshots from URL scan, the result, and the other relevant information that the scan picked up. So all this information can get included in your report and in your analysis so that you can make the appropriate decisions and make the appropriate recommendations. And it pulls all this information in. This has been a very quick demo of how to use the enrichment and how it can change your streamlining of your processes and your workflows so that you can use MISP as a single pane of glass for most, if not all, of the enrichment and event augmentation activities you typically go through. Thanks very much. If you have enjoyed this video and you want to get notified when the next video comes out, click the subscribe button and the bell and you will get that alert. Thanks very much. See you next time.